Consul of the FLQ sends this photograph of Cross to prove that he is still alive. While the frantic searches continue, a new movement to save Cross's life gets underway. The three major trades unions in Quebec sympathize with the social aims of the FLQ and oppose the War Measures Act. They overcome their long-standing differences and band together, and both the union leaders and the leaders of the Parti Québécois urge the government to give in to the demands of the FLQ to save the life of James Richard Cross. But those in power hold fast as Montreal prepares for a municipal election, an election many felt should have been postponed. The atmosphere is one of confusion, fear, and distrust, which lends itself to the stampeding of frightened voters. Two opposition candidates are arrested under the War Measures Act, and both Mayor Drapeau and Jean Marchand claim, incorrectly, to have discovered a link between the FLQ and the only serious opposition facing Drapeau, FRAP.
When a movement invites that kind of speaker, and when all the members that are attending the meeting, 3,000 of them apparently, according to the papers, are shouting the letters FLQ, FLQ, I don't think that we need much more evidence to say that there is more than just a moral sympathy.
And when you give these kind of powers to local authorities, you no longer know what use or abuse they're going to make of those powers. This is what troubles us. And you've already had examples of it. You've had an example in the city of Vancouver, where the mayor of that city says we can use these powers to clean out the hippies and the draft dodgers. You have a statement by the chief of police in one city on the prairies who said a lot of people that if you wanted to pick up, this would be a good time to do it. And now the growing suspicion, as pointed out by, for instance, Ron Haggart in the Toronto Telegram last night, that it looks very suspiciously like the regulations and these sweeping orders are going to be used in the province of Quebec, on the one hand to clean out FRAP, which is opposing Mayor Drapeau, and then the other hand to get rid of the separatists who have incurred, of course, the displeasure of both Mr. Choquette, the Attorney General, and Mr. Marchand.
No, we have no interest in the Montreal election. This is up to the citizens of Montreal to choose their councillors and their mayor, and we don't want to intervene at all in this.
But the fact is you have already intervened, sir, by what you said.
No, I didn't say that all members of the FRAP organization are members of the FLQ or anything of the kind. I just said that the FRAP, as a body, took a position which gave some kind of moral guarantee to the FLQ, that's all. But when I said that it was a front, I think it went too far, and this is the only thing I want to correct. As far as the rest is concerned, well, let's wait after the municipal election. And
what organization was going to create chaos in and around the Montreal election bombings?
Well, these are the things that we're going to clarify, I hope, in a few days.
This is an attempt to stampede the voters by a smear tactic, guilt by association. You take an organization and you, without any advancing any proof, without producing any evidence, you damn it by aligning it in the public mind with an organization that has just been declared by order and council to be an illegal organization.
To no one's surprise, Drapeau wins easily, winning every one of the 52 seats.
Merci à ceux qui ont permis.
Thank you to all those who, with their votes, have prevented democracy from suffering yet another, even more serious blow. I also wish to thank all those in the provincial and federal governments who understood that our system of government, for which so many of our people gave their lives in battles overseas, was in danger here. And who came forward to help this regime resist not only the known revolutionary attacks, but also the attempts to constitute a provisional government which would preside over the change from constitutional power to revolutionary power.
Few people realized that drapeau meant that there was a plot to overthrow the government of Quebec and replace it with a provisional government. Drapeau's far-fetched accusation is angrily denied by the prominent people implicated, including editor Claude Ryan, and the whole affair is buried by Bourassa.
I give you the reasons why I have to act to avoid more troubles. There is no question of provisional government being involved in my decision. I was told about that, about the possibility of such a thing, but I did not take that very seriously.
By now, the several police forces have managed to figure out the names of most of the kidnappers, and their descriptions and pictures are papered across Quebec. Bernard Lortie was the first Laporte suspect captured. Lortie was caught here on Queen Mary Road. But Paul and Jacques Rose and Francis Simard managed to escape by hiding in a cupboard behind a false wall while the police searched the apartment. As the weeks passed, a few people in English Canada finally began to protest the loss of civil liberties and to question the need for the War Measures Act.
It's a direct attack upon liberty. It's a direct attack upon freedom.
But the vast majority of the population continues to support the Prime Minister and his government's actions. The few people who do oppose the War Measures Act are far from popular.
And you with your progressive, got nothing to do.
Oh, I'm an idiot.
Canada, land of freedom,
freedom or a fort.
For the hundreds who are imprisoned here in Montreal's Parthenay jail, Canada is indeed a land of force.